That's it. Sorry, miss. Everybody knows it's so long.
Thank you. I'm still in the process of learning a new one. For many years I have wandered throughout this land. I've seen so much heartache on every hand.
Amen.
But then I think of all the times I could not make it on my own.
Amen.
He said, look up, child. You're soon coming home, and I can almost see the lights of that city, and I've seen sights like I've never seen before. I see the saints who have gone on, I see them gathering around. He said, look up, child, you're soon coming home. Now when I'm crossing over Jordan at the end of the way, I'll know my dear Savior when I hear him say,
what I've become these days.
Thank you. Sister, I love that song. And it's absolutely appropriate for what's been, God's been preaching for the last few weeks and services. And I'm just thrilled that I get to be here.
Amen.
Just to come and worship with you. Amen. That's what I come to do.
Amen.
I don't know what y'all can do, but I can worship.
Yes.
Oh, wonderful Lord. Amen. Because he's worthy.
Yes, he is.
Worthy.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin.
Amen.
Dwelt among men, my example is he. The word became flesh and the light shined among us. His glory
Yeah.
assigned him to do.
Yes.
Amen.
Paul.
Took care of all my sins, Mickey.
Yep.
Amen. Nailed him to a cross.
All of
yes, he did.
Took him off of that cross after he killed him up there. Took him in the grave with him.
Yeah.
Buried him. Rose up on the third day and left him there. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
If we can't celebrate that, if we can't get happy about that, if we can't shout over that, man, I'm going to tell you something. We got a problem.
Amen. That's right.
Amen. We got a problem. Reckon where we're going to be tonight in God's Word. We're going right back to Luke chapter number 15. Luke chapter number 15. Amen.
Amen.
Are you there?
Amen.
Did you have it marked?
Yes.
Amen. That's good. That's good. That means you're paying attention. I like that. Amen. We've been preaching on this series, recovering from bad decisions or being restored from bad decisions. Amen. And we've learned a lot of things about that process that God uses. We've learned that he is compassionate towards us. We've learned that when we come to ourselves, when we humble ourselves, and when we come back to him, that he covers us with his righteousness. He covers us with his blood. He covers us with his love.
Amen.
We've learned that he identifies himself with us, calls us his children, puts that ring on our finger, yes. Amen, that signet ring that symbolizes authority and kinship to the Father.
Yes, amen.
And we have that authority and that power in Christ because God has identified us as his children. We have been adopted into the family, into the kingdom of God. We are heirs and joint heirs with Jesus.
Yes.
Amen. Isn't that good?
Yeah, amen.
That's enough to say amen right there. Yeah, he didn't stop. He said, let me go on and do this. Get some shoes and put on their feet. Because I want to give them stability. I want to give them something, a firm foundation. I want to give them something solid to stand on, to launch from, to start from. And then I'm going to direct their path. I'm going to give them guidance. I'm going to give them direction in their life in the way that I want them to go. Because I know the end thereof. Amen. And it is life. And life eternal.
Yes.
When we allow God to direct us. And then he doesn't even stop there. The gifts keep on coming. He kills the fatted calf. Amen. Something of great value. Something he invests in you.
Yes. Amen.
And he places in you a flavor through his Holy Spirit. And he gives you joy unspeakable.
Yes.
Peace that passes all understanding. He gives you power to overcome.
Yes, he does.
Through his Holy Spirit, and that gives us flavor, and we become a sweet smell in the nostrils of God.
Yes, amen.
Isn't that good?
Amen.
Glory. Maybe it's just me. I'm excited.
Amen.
That fires me up.
Yes, come on.
Amen. And he doesn't stop there. He goes on to instruct us some more and show us some more of the gifts that he gives. Glory to God. Don't you know we have a wonderful God?
Amen.
We have a wonderful Father.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Who loves us and cares for us, not just all, but each.
Yes.
How many understand that God gives what we need right when we need it?
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Well, I want to talk to you tonight about the other member of the family. Now, I told you that God, every time we read about the Father in this parable, it's a representation of God the Father.
Yeah.
Amen. And when we read about the younger son, he is representative of the lost.
Yes.
And those who need to come to Christ. Yeah. Amen. Now we're going to talk about, and we're going to meet this other member of the family.
Yes,
the older brother.
Oh, yeah.
Reckon what he represents, Mickey. He represents the church.
Yes,
you see. Well, now, wait a minute, preacher. How you know that? Give me just a minute. We'll see what he says, all right? Let's look in verse number 25. Verse number 25, he said, now his elder son was in the field, and as he came and drew nigh to the house, he heard music and dancing. And he called one of the servants and asked what these things meant. And he said unto him, thy brother is come, and thy father hath killed the fatted calf because he hath received him safe and sound.
Amen.
Let me park right there just a minute. You see there? How important that fatted calf. He didn't say nothing about the robe.
No.
He didn't say nothing about the ring. Didn't say nothing about the shoes. He said he's killed the fatted calf. What he is basically saying to this older brother, man, your dad has thrown down because your brother has come home safe and sound, and your father has received him, and he has killed the best calf. Man, he is throwing out some big bucks on your brother. And they're turning out because he's in the field. And not only did they have the DJ cranking, but the dancing was so out. He heard that.
Yeah, amen.
Must have been Riverdale. Amen. They were celebrating. They were having a time. They were throwing down in the house. Partying. Don't get mad at the preacher if he dances in church, because I can show you several places in here in this Bible where they danced.
Amen.
I'm not talking about hoochie mama dancing. I'm talking about dancing in celebration of God.
Yes.
Amen. Look at verse number 28. And he was angry and would not go in. He was angry and would not go in. That's the first thing I want us to look at tonight. The brothers. Anger. Well, that was insightful. It's wrote down in these big red letters in my Bible.
Yeah.
He was angry. The brother was angry after what the servant had told him what was going on. Why? Have you ever asked the question, why? What was he angry about? What made him so mad? What got him so tore up? His brother had come back home.
Bless
me. Now maybe he was a little put out with his brother for leaving in the first place. Maybe he was a little tore up over that. But why was he so angry? Because he wouldn't even go into that. We're throwing down, your brother come home and we've killed the fatted calf. Man, we are partying in here. We are dancing.
Yeah.
Everybody's having a great time. Come on in. I ain't gonna do it. I ain't gonna do that. That joker. Tore up.
Yeah.
See, some people think they have a right to be angry.
Come on.
And we've talked about this. I could spend the whole rest of my time on anger again. But we've talked about this, and there is some times that we ought to be angry, some things we ought to get angry about.
Yeah.
Amen? But we ought not to get angry over celebrating for somebody else.
Yeah.
Amen. Yes, give him praise and glory.
Amen.
Thank you for that, Lord.
Yeah.
See, we you know what the problem is? The problem is rooted deep in this young man. See, we would say in our society today, in our socially engineered culture, socially engineered by secular humanists, and we would say he needs anger management.
Yeah.
We need to teach better and more anger. Listen, we don't need anger management. We need anger resolution.
Come on. Yeah.
You understand that? We need to learn how to resolve the anger, not management. Listen, anything man tries to manage eventually blows up.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. It eventually dries up, blows away, or goes away. Amen.
Yeah.
The track record for man's management skills is not really good.
No.
Nope.
Amen. And so we try to manage these things. And see, I believe that God gives us anger to reveal to us, that's a light that he puts in us, to reveal to us that there's something wrong inside. There's a problem inside us. This young man had some anger issues. He had some issues deep rooted in his heart. He was tore up.
Yeah.
Most anger comes from the fact that most of us think that we're owed something.
Yes.
And so we can't celebrate with someone else because they have something, because we're too tore up because we ain't got it. Think we're owed something.
Yeah.
Anger is a sign that you have an unyielded right. You think that I have some right to some, I have a right to be in, I have a right to this, or I have a right to that. You are not your own.
Amen.
You've been bought with a price.
Amen.
And a dear price. The very blood.
That's it.
Of God the Son. So if I have yielded my life to Him, if I have given myself to Him, it's not mine anymore. No. It's His. What we need to learn to do is to yield that over to God. Because whatever comes into my life, whatever trouble, whatever sorrow, whatever difficulty, whatever heartache, nothing can come into my life if I am His without His knowledge and approval.
Amen. Amen. That's right. Amen.
I didn't say He caused it.
No.
I didn't say He brought it. But it cannot come to me if I have the hedge of protection of my Father around me without Him allowing it to come to me. And why would He do that? Because He's going to teach me something through it.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to grow me. He's going to strengthen me through that. And but our problem is we don't yield it to God.
Yeah.
Amen. Verse 27, this young man. To him, thy brother is come, and thy father killed the fatted calf, because he hath received him safe and sound. And he was angry and would not go in. Therefore came his father out and entreated him. That's my second point, the father's plea.
My
father came out and pled with him. Come on in. Your brother is at home. He was lost, and now he's found.
Yes, amen.
He said, come on in. And he answering, look at the brother's response to what he said. But the father, to the father's pleas, answered to his father, lo, these many years do I serve thee, neither transgressed I at any time thy commandments, liar, yet thou never gavest me a kid, even a young goat. You didn't even give me a goat, and that I could make merry with my friends. Now maybe the brother's got a point, but the problem is there's a little bit of self-righteousness in his response to his father.
Yeah.
I'd have been here all this time. I ain't never done nothing wrong.
Yeah.
And you ain't give me so much as a goat.
Yeah.
So that I can party with my friends. Self-righteousness. Entitlement. Attitude. See, he couldn't celebrate his brother's return. He couldn't celebrate with everybody else because he was too worried about what he hadn't got.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah.
Can I make a statement to you?
Come on.
Now, this is the truth.
Yeah.
You might not like it.
Bless you, Lord.
But take it up with God, not me. Okay?
Bless you.
From Genesis to Revelations, nowhere in this book does it say God is fire. Nowhere. It doesn't. You know what it says? He's just. He is just. And He gives what we as individuals need right at the time we need it.
Yeah, amen.
You might not have needed that fatty calf. But I did. See. And if you can't celebrate with me, because if you worried about what you ain't got, you got the problem, not me.
That's right.
Because God has granted me this, given me this, gifted me this.
Yeah.
Not because I deserved it. The boy didn't deserve it.
Neither one of them.
Amen. Neither one of them. But the older brother couldn't celebrate with him. That's the problem we have in the church today.
Amen. That's right.
That's the problem we have. You see, that's why we're not winning people to Christ. That's why we're not working in the fields. That's why we're not out gathering the harvest. Because we're too worried about what Joe's got and I ain't.
Come on. Bless you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Pride.
Yeah.
You hear the pride? In that statement?
Yeah.
I've been a member of this church for 40 years. I believe that grants me a little seniority. I had a man say that to me one day. I believe that entitles me to a little seniority. I got bad news for you then. You see, the member that's been here 40 years is exactly the same as the one that joined yesterday.
Yes, amen.
We're all in the same family, all in the same room. But what you ought to be mature enough to help that one that joined yesterday.
Amen.
You ought to be mature enough to bring that one along, disciple that one along. But if you're too worried because they sat in your seat on Sunday morning.
Come on.
Visited the church one time. Me and Helen. Sat down. Getting ready for church. I mean, I was looking forward to it, excited about it. And all of a sudden, about 5 minutes before church starts, hey, buddy, you're going to have to move. My wife and I have been sitting there 40 years. The seat in front of me was empty. The seat behind me was empty. The seat beside me was empty.
Amen.
But far be it from me to hinder him from his worship.
Yeah.
I said, come on, man, let's just move. I will worship in the parking lot.
Amen.
I don't have to have a seat with my name on it.
No.
I said, come on in here, brother. Don't let me get in your way.
Yeah.
Sit down there, enjoy yourself. Amen. Entitled. Pride. Think they got seniority.
Yeah.
Amen. That's what this brother thought. He said, you ain't even give me so much as a goat to party with my friend. I'm entitled to something. I've been here all this time. I've stayed right here with you. I ain't done nothing wrong. I ain't run off and spent your money on hookers and booze and drugs and whatever else. I haven't done that stuff. I've been right here all this time. I ought to be entitled to a little something.
Yep.
See, a lot of church members think that God hears their prayer and they ought to get what they want, you see, because they done been there for so long. Self-righteousness. Here it is. God doesn't answer your prayer based on your righteousness.
That's right. Amen.
He doesn't answer my prayer based on my righteousness. Praise his high and holy name, let you know. Because my righteousness on my best day is as filthy rags and a stench in the nostrils of God. That's why he put the robe on me. That's why he put the ring on me. That's why he put the shoes on me. You see, because I'm his. He clothed me in his righteousness so I could make it to his throne.
Amen.
And approach him as my father. And God owes us something because we done been in this thing a long time. We've done good.
That's
you know. Amen. I ain't never done like him. Ever. Look at it. And he answered his father and said, lo, these many years I serve thee. Neither transgress thee I at any time thy commandment, yet thou never gave me a key that I might make merry with my friend. But as soon as this thy son,
come on,
psh, mm-hmm. He's done divorced himself from him.
Yes.
He ain't even his brother anymore. As soon as this thy son was come, which hath devoured thy living with harlots, thou hast killed for him the fatted calf. Good as I done been to you. And you done give him the fatted calf. You throwing him a party.
Yeah.
Celebrate the fact that he run off.
Yeah.
Blew all your money. I ain't never done none of that stuff. Let me tell you something. You ain't never done it because of the grace of God.
Yeah, amen.
Yeah. Amen. We have too many smug, long-nosed people in the church looking over their glasses and saying, I ain't never did nothing like that. You ought to praise God.
Yeah, amen.
Because you almost did. Yeah. You almost did, or you didn't get caught.
Yeah.
Most likely. Amen. I ain't never been in jail because they didn't have cameras back then.
No.
You see, you steal that thing. Amen. I never had a child out of wedlock. It wasn't because you didn't go through the mechanics.
Come on.
Can't handle the truth this night. Amen. I knew that would be much. Amen.
Listen, Lord.
Amen. 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 I ain't never done it. I ain't never had that. I ain't never been hooked on drugs. I've never been no alcoholic by the grace of God.
Yeah,
amen.
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 Yeah.
You ought to praise God and thank him for the things you ain't done.
Right.
That's right.
Because it was him cutting that deal off. You know you cut. Yeah, amen. Yeah. You thought about it.
Yeah.
You considered it. Yeah. You probably even made some plans to do it.
Yeah.
A few times. And before you could seal the deal, God cut that thing off. He put something in your path.
Yeah.
Amen. His head, you run into his head. Amen. See, that head's protected from the outside and the inside.
Okay.
Amen. And we look down our long, smug, righteous noses at people who have fallen by the wayside and wandered away. My. Shame on us four times.
Come on.
Amen. Amen. God. You ain't never even given me as much as you're going to give him the fatted calf. Can I make an announcement today from the Word of God? God doesn't owe you and God doesn't owe me anything.
Amen.
What I have by the grace and mercy, long suffering, and gentleness and kindness of God.
Amen.
That's it. Amen.
Amen.
Now look at the Father's truth. We see the brother's anger. We hear the Father's plea. We hear the brother's response. And now look at the Father's truth that he gives him. He said, and he said unto him, Son, remember, his Father is representing Father God. When he put that covering, when he put that robe on this young man, he put that robe on you. When he put that ring on his finger, he put that on your finger. When he put those shoes on his feet, he put that those shoes on you. When he killed that fatted calf, he killed it very best for you.
Yes, amen.
And for me. Glory. And then he calls us son. Just give me glory, Bob.
Amen.
Amen. And he said unto him, Son, thou art ever with me, and all that I have is thine.
Yep. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Do you see it? Do you see it?
Amen.
The Father's truth. Always. With me.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You think that what he went and spent was the best? You think that what he went and wasted on his righteous living, you think that, listen, you have had the crowning glory. You have always been with me.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Never left you, never forsaken you. I've been here closer even than your
yes.
own brother.
Amen.
Amen. You have always been with me. That's the best.
Yeah, amen.
That's the wonder of it all. You've always been with me.
Mm. Oh, my God. Hey,
blessed
Lord.
Amen. And he didn't even realize what he had.
Yep.
We don't realize what we have when we just come into the presence of Almighty God. We come flippantly. We come as if we're entitled to something. We come expecting something. But the presence, just being with him, is the crowning jewel of it all.
Amen. Amen. That's right.
We're never alone. Mm-hmm. He's always with us.
Hey.
And then he said it. You've always been with me. He said that. Everything I have is yours.
Yeah.
Amen.
Everything that I have is yours. Did you see it?
Amen. Yes,
you
amen.
Get it?
Amen.
Go to the Father. I am an heir.
Yeah, amen.
Praise the Lord.
To the kingdom.
Amen.
Of God.
Yeah, amen.
All that I have is yours.
Yeah.
Everything that God has is yours.
Amen.
If you've trusted in him, if you've surrendered to him, if you've denied yourself, taken up your cross, and followed him, all of it belongs to you.
Amen.
I'm an heir and a joint heir with Jesus.
Amen.
Did you get that?
Yeah.
No, you don't. You'd be shouting the roof off of this place. I'm an heir and a joint heir with Jesus.
Yeah.
Everything that Jesus had, I now have.
Amen.
I have the power to tread upon serpents and scorpions. Amen. I have the power to run through armies and jump over walls. I have the power to tell the devil to get out of my house, get out of my life, leave my kids alone. I have that power, and I've got his ring. I've got the authority, and he has to listen. Amen. He has to listen. The problem is we sit and we wring our hands and say, oh, I don't know what I can do. I don't know what to do. Get up and fight.
Yeah.
Get up and fight. Get in the fight and stay in the fight. When it gets ugly, get meaner. Amen. When it gets hard, get harder. Amen. Yeah. Some of you have been going through some struggles. Somebody here tonight has been going through a struggle in a valley. Amen. And you've been trying to climb up out of that valley. You've been trying to make it over that mountain. You've been climbing up, as the old song says, the rough side of the mountain. And the rocks are falling on you. And every time you take four steps, you slide back two. But you keep on struggling. You keep on going, well, I want you to know something. I want you to know something. Mike, what day is it, brother? What day is it? It's hump day. This is the day you're going to get over the hump. This is the day God's going to lift you up of it. This is the day he's going to deliver you from it and out of it. It's hump day for somebody. Amen. Because I am an heir of Almighty God. He's my Father. I'm his Son. Glory. Hallelujah. And all that he has is at my disposal.
Thank you.
Isn't that good?
Amen.
Glory. Hallelujah. Don't wring your hand and say, what am I going to do? Don't make God your last chance. Make him your first choice.
Yeah.
Put on the whole armor of God. Pick up your sword of the Spirit. Amen.
Yeah.
The shield of faith, the helmet of salvation, and the breastplate of his righteousness. Gird yourself in the truth of his gospel. Charge your feet in the preparation of the gospel of peace. And get in the fight.
Yeah.
Get in the fight. And stay in the fight until the battle's won.
Amen.
Oh, my. My. It was good that we should make merry and be glad. For this thy brother was dead and is alive again. Was lost and now he's found.
Yes.
See, we celebrate over the wrong things. We want to celebrate over the wrong thing. We'd celebrate if we had this many in Sunday school and had this many in worship. And I like it. I love people. And the more you fit in here and squeeze in here and cram in here, the better I'll be. But listen, that's not what causes my heart to leap in my chest.
Yeah.
That's not what causes the glory bumps to come out on my heart. What causes when one lost sinner comes on, when one who has strayed and gone away comes back to God, amen, regives himself unto him, cries out, oh daddy, help me. I've messed up.
Yep.
Amen.
That's what we ought to celebrate. That's what ought to bring us the most joy.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Not looking down our nose, not wondering if it's real, or taking a pool on how long it'll last.
Yep.
Listen, you get hooked on some of this stuff, man, it's going to take a while. You know? Just like I said this morning, the fatted calf didn't get fat overnight.
No.
It took a while. It took some work. Amen. Same thing. Listen, that robe that he put on him, it didn't erase all of those things.
No.
It covered them.
Yes.
Propitiation.
Yeah, amen.
King James called it absolute, full, and complete covering.
Yeah.
He still got some things to deal with. And he needs help.
Yep. Yeah.
Dealing with those things. He doesn't need a brother. He doesn't need a brother angry with him because he was received back into the fold. He doesn't need a brother angry with him because they had to sweep the house to find the corn. He doesn't need a brother angry with him because he got a calf and he didn't. He was received back. Amen.
Amen.
And he was angry. Tore up from the floor. Because his father was rejoicing to have his child back home. Amen. But what's the point of these parables? When you shake it down, press it down, mold it down, what's it all mean? You answer that for yourself. Let's pray. Father God, I love you. I praise you and I thank you for your goodness, your power, your mercy, and your grace. I thank you, God, that you are always with me. I thank you, God, that I'm an heir to the kingdom. Father, I praise you for that moment because I don't deserve one bit of it. But only through your grace and your kindness, your long-suffering, your mercy, and your love, oh Father, have you bestowed those gifts on me. And I praise you and thank you. In Jesus' name and for his sake, amen.
Amen.
And amen. Glory to God. All right. Thank you for your kind attention. I love you. I hope this has been, this series has been a blessing to you because it sure has to me.
Amen.
Oh, my. What wonderful truth. What wonderful truths throughout this entire chapter. And even on the 16, and we might just bounce right on into 16 next week, amen. Because it's going to get at the heart of some matters, amen. You know, nothing tears a family apart like money, stuff. That's what tore this family up. That's what this brother was so mad about, the stuff.
Yeah.
You gave him the fatted calf.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how many times I've been to people's home where some mom and dad has gone and the brothers and sisters are fighting and fussing and arguing over who's going to get what.
Yeah, yes. Amen.
Over, arguing over a plate.
Yeah.
I know two sisters.
Mom.
That have not spoken for 15 years over a plate.
Yes.
That was their grandma. One of them got it and the other one didn't.
Yes.
A plate. I'll tell you what I'd do if I was her husband. I'd take that plate up in the yard and shoot it. Blow it into a million pieces. I would.
Amen.
They'd be targets. There'd be ripples in my pond, but they'd talk. They'd talk about me, but they'd talk. You ain't believe what he did. Amen. See, what's the matter with it? Let me share this with you, brother. This is going to be free. It's ain't part of the message. I'm charging nickel. Okay? When two people come together in matrimony, in that covenant, you don't just bring you and her. You bring her family and your family together. Amen. You bring all of your assets and liabilities and all of her assets and liabilities and the twain become one. You see. Amen. Oh, don't get off on the, get on the good foot, brother.
Amen.
Ain't no mine and hers.
Right.
It's just ours.
Yeah.
It's ours. I never ever understood that. Some people that have two budget things. That's her money, that's my money.
No.
What? Prenuptial agreement, charity. Amen. It's the dumbest thing I ever heard of in my life. If I keep trusting with my money, I don't need to marry her. And if she can't trust me, she don't need to marry me. That is not who God has picked.
Come on. Amen.
Amen. Money, stuff, junk. That's what had this family told her. Stuff. And they missed the big picture. Always been with me. Everything I have belongs to you. Amen.
Yeah.
Anything on anybody's heart? I'm about to preach another message. Anybody think on anybody's heart or mind before this means?
I really enjoyed the message.
Amen.
This series. But let's remember Brother Damon. He's been going through some pain here for the last little bit. And let's pray for him. Pray for the church, pray for the, for everything. Everybody's had special requests for him.
Yes.
I was thinking the other, this week, you know, a lot of times we worry about some things we hear about. We'll worry about it, or what happened is, or what, you know, but we don't get burdened with it.
Yes.
You know, and I think that's for,
amen,
a lot of us as Christians, we don't take it as a burden. We don't see it through.
Amen.
We want to be worried about it, but we don't want to see it through.
Amen. That's right. Amen. Anyone else?
I've enjoyed the sermons too. The last couple of weeks have been great. I wish we had more people. You know, I always say that.
Amen.
This person needs to hear this. I mean, I can think of so many this would have done good, but it's done me good.
Amen.
And I think sometimes I do that. I say, I wish this person was here. When really the Lord's, the way you portrayed it tonight showed me that it's not just about the prodigal or somebody being lost. It's about the church. How we respond as, to things as Christians.
Amen.
It affects our church. So,
amen.
You did real wonderful tonight.
God bless you. Amen. Anyone else?
Hey, I think that before we leave, I think we should go to you and pray for you.
I appreciate that. Come on, brother. What's your name? Those that don't know, I've been having issues with my dog. And it's right pain. not constant. Knife pain, but pray for me. Figure out what we'll do
today. Rick, go ahead and lead us, brother.
Lord, we just come before you right now, Father. We lift Brother Dean up to you, Father. You know each and every part of his body, Father. You know each and every hair that he doesn't have on his head. You know every vessel. Father, you know everything that's going on with it. We turn it over to you, Father, that you will just touch him in a mighty way. Father, that you will heal him where he needs healing. Strengthen where he needs strength, Father. We just turn it over to you. And Father, we put him into your hand because you know what is best for him, Father. You know his future and his future steps. Father, we're turning it over to you. It's outside of our hands, Father. We love you. We praise you. We know that you're going to do a miracle and a mighty work in his name.
Yes.
And Father, we just can't wait to sit back and watch it, Father. We love you and we praise you.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Biggest thing is it's affecting my cheeseburger in
there. Oh, wow.